What's up with you, lad? What are you waiting for?
I'm waiting for my brother to be released.
Your brother?
The one that you caught, beat up and imprisoned.
Ah, the murderer.
He ain't killed no one, copper.
Watch your mouth, lad, else you'll be joining that worthless brother of yours.
Please escort this suspect for interrogation.
Good evening, Mr. Chapman.
Who are you? I've got nothing to say. It's all a mistake.
Calm down, Layton. I have come here to help you. To find out if you truly are innocent, as your younger brother Wiggins has told me.
My brother? You know him? Then that means you're...
Sherlock Holmes.
Oh, blimey. All right, Mr. Holmes. I'll tell you everything.
Good. Tell me your account of what happened.
I left my work, and I hurried up to see the fireworks in Whitechapel. I was late, so I decided to cut through off Moon Street. I saw the first fireworks light up in the sky. I bumped into a constable on a corner before entering Half Moon. Then suddenly, what with all the firework flare, I saw two men. They were both lying flat in the middle of the street. I stopped where I was. I thought about turning back to the police, but as I was thinking of that, I saw a third person. He was leaning over the body that was furthest from me. The second I saw him, he raised his head and he stared at me. In a flash, I saw his gun, but he made a dash for it instead and he escaped through Whitechapel Street.
So you might still have had time to return to the constable.
I panicked. I didn't know what to do. Anyway, I approached the bodies just to see if they were still alive. I saw that one had blood pumping out of his stomach. He was dying. It was horrible. The second one was already dead. He had a hole in his head. He was holding a gun in his hand, though. I took it, and then I followed the third man.
Interesting. Pray, continue.
I turned a corner, and I saw the man standing in the middle of the street. He seemed to be in some sort of panic. And then, Mr. Holmes, something strange happened. I told the police and they laughed at what I said, but I swear to you, my words are true. I started running towards him. But then I was blinded by a flash. It was so bright that I hardly saw anything for a good dozen seconds. But I kept running forward. As I arrived in Whitechapel, I heard a woman screaming. And then I was caught by the police. But there wasn't a trace of that man. Of course, then they found a gun and all that blood. I couldn't see the murderer escaping and all that mess. Perhaps I was still half-blinded at that moment.
A thrilling account, my young man. Layton, are you able to describe the person whom you saw standing in Half Moon Street?
Well, I wasn't able to see his face at all. It was too dark, and he was too far away. I could see his silhouette.
And what about that?
Nothing so special. He was wearing a jacket. He was quite average in size and his weight.
I see. Was there anything else that struck you at the time?
No. But perhaps... It's strange, but I can't remember the sound of his footsteps as he was running away. Perhaps it was because of the fireworks or the surprise of me seeing him.
Layton, I confess I am puzzled. Why should a young lad like you take a gun from the hands of a dead man and set off in pursuit of a probable killer?
I know. I keep wondering that, but at the time it was like a reflex. A criminal ought to be arrested, and he was armed.
You were willing to risk your life. That was a little foolish, unless you wanted revenge.
No, Mr. Holmes. I was just being brave and stupid.
I'm sure that you were, but I believe that you may have recognized one of the victims, Brian Vercotti. You knew that gentleman well, did you not?
How ever could you know that?
You have a typical tattoo of the Westgate Brotherhood upon your hand. I observed exactly the same mark upon Mr. Vercotti. You came to know him from your sharing a past prison sentence. Am I correct, Mr. Chapman?
Oh, God. You're right, Mr. Holmes.
Would you tell me a little about Brian Vercotti?
We were convicted for a robbery. Once in prison, both of us joined one of his fraternities. During that year, we tried to help each other out, you know?
Now, you were quite young then, I believe.
Yes, Mr. Holmes, we were. We'd only stolen a pound of meat. After we were released, and when I saw what my little brother had become, I decided to work towards living an honest life.
And Vercotti?
He had a hard time. His sister had died in a Whitechapel dispensary while he was in prison. He had no family anymore. Our paths split. He fell back into crime.
So you lost him?
Yes. And for around 2 years, I heard no news of him at all.
We shall see you soon, young man.
Crampons and a sharp ice axe would only be brought here by a mountaineer.
Why are you looking at me all the time like that?
I'm just watching you, lad. I never know what to expect from people like you.
People like me?
Yes, street beggars and thieves.
I ain't a thief.
Oh, no? Then where did you get whatever it is that you're gnawing on? I very much doubt that you bought it.
What ain't seen can't hardly be stolen.
It would be my pleasure to assist you with your investigation, Mr. Holmes.
Mr. Holmes, did you see my brother at Scotland Yard? Is he all right?
Unable to see any higher, I need to find something to lift my lamp. This should be useful. This is most definitely a bullet hole. The brick cracks are fresh. Watson, there was a third shot fired in this street.
Constable Marrow, I would value your assistance in this investigation.
It would be my pleasure, Mr. Holmes.
I would like to make sure that there are no places in Half Moon Street where a man could hide while you were running through it with your lamp.
All right, Mr. Holmes, what should I do?
Take your lamp and start walking, just as you did before, and try to find me.
Understood.